Hello, so today we're going to look at proof of work. Proof of work is an algorithm, and to quote from the Mastering Bitcoin book, it is a hash algorithm that takes an arbitrary length data input and produces a fixed length deterministic result, a digital fingerprint of the input. For any specific input, the resulting hash will always be the same and can be easily calculated and verified by anyone implementing the same hash algorithm. So let's look at some example code and see what we can learn in Rust.
Okay, so I've imported ring using cargo add. I've set up a constant for the difficulty, and that is usize 4. I'm still learning Rust, and it seems to be that usize is possibly better for when you may have an unknown size number or a very large number. To be honest, usize probably is not going to be necessary, but it could just be a U8 really, because the actual hash length is only going to be 256 bits because we're using SHA256. So maybe I don't need to use usize there. I don't know. Anyway, I've written a function, and the function is the one and only function that gets used inside of main. What it does, it checks if the hash produced by our data plus the number called the nonce, if the hash of those two produces the required hash, which has the required number of zeros at the start. Let's run it. Let me just run this code and then you'll see what happens, and then we'll come back and talk about it some more. And I'll also talk about a couple of things that I learned when I was doing it. So what's going on? I've got caps lock on, sorry. Right. So I've run it already, you can see there. So if we do cargo run quiet, and this should take a few seconds. And you can see it's generating all the hashes. Because I'm printing them, it's taking slightly longer. And once it gets to this number, 89308, plus my data, when those two are added together and the hash of them, the product is actually 0000. So that's the difficulty. The difficulty we set to be 4. And those are our 4 zeros. So if we go back and look at the code, that's what I'm looking for, the 4 zeros. The difficulty, so I'm passing in the hash as a string or a string slice, even. The difficulty, which also gets passed into the function when we use it, and it returns a Boolean, so true or false. Does it meet the difficulty requirements, yes or no? So it's actually saying it will be true if the hash string starts with, so 0. So that's 0, but it's in quotes. So it's actually it's not even a character, is it? It's actually a string, a short string. Well, basically, it will be a string because we use repeat here. It's the first time I've used repeat. So basically, it's naught times whatever this number is, the difficulty. We know it's 4. So repeat is basically repeating naught 4 times. Then in main, we pass in the data. So hello world. The nonce will start at 0. Then we enter a loop. And basically the loop is going to keep iterating until it breaks on a successful or true value from the meet difficulty function. Now, that's kind of the overview of how it works. It's probably worth me just saying the things which caught me out when I was writing it. I didn't want to attempt to try and live code this because I couldn't have done it live. But I think there's a few things which are worth pointing out with the benefit of hindsight, now that I've actually written it and got it working. We've got ampersand there. Now, that is because SHA256 is basically the algorithm, and we want to just reference that. We don't want to copy it each time we enter the loop, because that would be expensive. We use a context. Now, we don't have to, not for this code, it's a feature which is provided with ring context. What it does is it allows you to make a mutable context and then update it. So we add the data as bytes, and the data is hello world. And then we need to add the nonce. On each iteration, the nonce gets incremented by one. See that there? So if at first you don't succeed, then try again. So if hello world and a nonce of zero doesn't produce a hash with four zeros at the start, then we'll increment the nonce. I had to use write there instead of format, and that's still something I need to really fully understand. We're using the digest. So the digest is basically you have some data, you have your hashing algorithm. So that's the algorithm. That's not actually doing the hashing. The digest is the variable, which is basically your context, and then it's, you do finish on it. So that is actually what's creating the hash. And then here, we iterate over it, and we are converting the bytes back to hex, and then we print. And if it's successful, we break the loop. Let me just try and remember some other things which caught me out. At one point, I was getting a compile message which was telling me to clone, and that didn't seem right. And I ran cargo Clippy, which I must admit I don't always do, but cargo Clippy, if you've not used cargo Clippy, it will spot errors in your code. Even if your code works or compiles, cargo Clippy will find, it will spot where you could improve things. At the end, I'm just printing, and I'm not using the colorize or the colorize crate. I'm just doing this without using any additional crates. That's what prints it blue, because light blue is equal to this. You're never going to remember that, but just look it up or Google it. So that's to actually generate the hash. And we don't just want to take the computer's word for it. So in here, I've also got check py. Python 3.10 check py. I'll run it. And we'll look at the code. So my Python code agrees, or it confirms, that it's a valid hash. So let's just go and look at that. I know this is kind of mainly a Rust channel, but I just thought this would be interesting to show anyway. So hashlib. And hashlib is actually really fast. And I thought running it in Python would be slow, but it's not, because that's obviously, or presumably that's written in C and runs at C-like speed. So this is effectively doing the same thing. It's returning a hash that starts with 0 times difficulty. So in Rust, we were using 0.repeat and then difficulty in brackets. So effectively the multiply there is, yeah. Python does make certain things a lot easier, doesn't it? So here we're using a while loop, whereas in Rust we had just the loop, which was called loop. And here we're encoding nonce, and then we take we encode the data, and ultimately we hash the data plus the nonce to bytes, and it's big endian. We're taking the first 8 bytes. Here we're just saying if it meets the difficulty. So again, that's the meets difficulty, which will return. So yeah, Python doesn't show you what it's returning, but it's actually it's returning the hash starts with difficulty. But really, if that's true, then it will print found valid hash, blah blah blah, break. Otherwise, it will do the same as the Rust code, which was nonce plus equals one. So that's the Python code, which checks. To be honest, you could run Python code and then check it with Rust either way. But for the purpose of this video and this channel and for me, what I really wanted to do was write it in Rust. And so when you're using Ring, you need to use you can use context. And effectively, you take the data plus a nonce, and then you use digest. And I'm still getting the hang of when to use as underscore ref. And formatting between bytes to hex to binary. Again, that's still... So that's basically doing some padding. It's saying split it into chunks of two. In if it doesn't need the two digits, then just pad it out to two. So there we go. Proof of work. Proof of work is an algorithm which is used by. I'm not going to keep talking about Bitcoin blockchain or anything because I know some people have got a bit of hang up about it, but it is used by them, and it's a very useful way of proving that you've done some computation, shall we say. So yeah, I've put the link, I'll put the link to a Rust playground in the video description. Hopefully that's useful. If you run it in Rust playground actually runs very fast, and it you don't have to do the cargo add, because let's go and have a look at cargo. Let's look at cargo toml. That's another thing I'll mention in a second. So, yeah. What have I done? I tried to install something called Flame Graph, and I've yet to get it working, but I don't know if anybody can offer any advice on that. It's operating system dependent. I've got it installed, but when I run it, I'm going into cd target debug, and then I do flame graph. My binary is called ring learn. Needs two lots of colons. Dashes even. I don't know. That's something to work on. So if anybody has used Flame Graph even, then yeah, let me know. So there we go. Thanks for watching.